Subscribe and click the bell icon for all the television updates.
छवि मित्तल ने हाल ही में अपने डिलीवरी के बाद अपनी हियरिंग इम्पेयरमेंट के बारे में बताया था, मगर अब उन्होंने शेयर की अपने बच्चे की बर्थ स्टोरी। उन्होंने बताया कि वो किस तरह से डरी हुई थी अपनी डिलीवरी के पहले और क्यों। उन्होंने ये भी बताया कि किस तरह उन्हें अपने हस्बैंड के साथ की जरूरत थी, मगर डॉक्टर्स ने उन्हें ऑपरेशन थिएटर में आने नहीं दिया। उन्होंने इंस्टाग्राम का सहारा लेते हुए अपनी कहानी बयां की। माय ब्यूटीफुल हिप्नो बर्थ, अ लॉस्ट बैटल, चैप्टर 1, अ ड्रीम कम ट्रू। इट वॉज मदर्स डे, द परफेक्ट सेटिंग टू हैव अ बेबी। आई हेल्ड द बेबी इन टिल द बेबी गेव मी साइंस दैट इट वॉन्टेड टू कम आउट। आई वेंट इन टू नेचुरल लेबर एट 10 PM व्हेन आई वॉज टकिंग इन माई लिटिल अरीजा। I didn't know at the time that it was going to be my last time alone with her for a long time. Instinctively, she didn't want to leave me and kept coming back after repeated good nights and hugs. And instinctively, I knew that my long-delayed hospital stay was going to begin tonight. Sure enough, my mucus plug came off soon after Ariza slept, and I went to the hospital, all bags packed, on the doctor's advice. At 1 AM, my membranes is released, and by 6 AM the next morning, I was already 7 cm dilated. No epidural, just medication and an extremely loving and caring husband by my side. One of the most important things about hypnobirthing is that the birthing experience is shared equally by the mother and father both. It was Mohit's responsibility to allow the birth to progress naturally, controlling me in case I felt weak in my resolve for an all-natural birth, to light up my labor room with candles, incense and fairy lights, to play calming music, to do pain relief massages, to remind me to drink water and eat high energy foods, and to hold my hand when I went to the washroom, which was every 15 minutes I think, or at least it felt so. I even slept through some of the labor. It was so peaceful and relaxing. I would wake up every 2 minutes, breathe through a surge and drift off again. My beautiful hypno birth was progressing, and a little baby was going to emerge out of my birth canal and straight onto my breast. But my beautiful hypno birth, a lost battle. Chapter 2, The Panic Begins. At 8 AM, my doctor came into my room and administered a drug intravenously. Within seconds, I felt dizzy. I felt weak. My throat started to choke and I threw up. I panicked. She said this was just to hasten the dilation. I don't know why we needed to hasten it though, but you gotta trust your doctor. Right that second, I was thrown out of my calming and peaceful zone. I couldn't do the calm breaths anymore. I could see my dream birth slipping away from my hands. Another thing about hypnobirthing is that it has to be all natural. The minute you start administering drugs, it becomes medicalized, sort of defeats the whole purpose, which is why I had shared my typed birth plan with the entire hospital staff, the head of the hospital, the doctor, the nursing staff, the pediatrician, and everyone who was remotely involved. Some snippets. Mohit will be by my side every single minute. He will not leave even for paperwork. Hence, we made the entire payment weeks in advance. Allow us time, no rushing with labor. Delayed cord clamping after the birth. Allow the placenta to stop pulsating before cutting. 50% of the baby's blood lies in the placenta, and the baby needs it to breathe in the first few minutes of birth and needs the blood to come back to its body. The damage that the early clamping of cord causes is way too great. Give the baby to the mother before any kind of testing. All tests wait for 15 minutes. There were various other small things that were mentioned in the birth plan, and we were assured that all our requests will be respected. After we got the assurance we needed, we were sure that our choice of doctor and caregivers was indeed right. We put our trust in them, because there's no greater trust than the one you put in the person who brings your unborn to this world. But was our decision right? Only time was to tell. To be continued. Chapter 3, The Worst Was Yet to Come. Due to the panic attack post the drug, my dilation completely stopped. I failed to go back into hypnosis. For the next 7 hours, I felt no progress. At 1 PM, I was put on Pitocin. My surges started coming every 30 seconds and lasted for 2 minutes each. I was in excruciating pain, but still determined to bring my baby into the world naturally. I started dilating again, and 2 hours later, I was 8 cm dilated. But my doctor came in and said she would like to take me for a C-section. I put my complete faith in her and agreed to whatever she said. But her attitude towards my whole birthing process completely shook me up. She said some things which I could not respond to at that time, but they will remain engraved in my mind forever. This person who was with me through this journey of 9+ months, this person who had seen my strengths and weaknesses, who had seen me naked physically and emotionally, She told me, your labor is not strong enough. Your body is not meant to do this. If you felt pain, you would be screaming, not sleeping. That was the first time I realized that she was never on board the hypnobirthing to begin with. If she was, she would believe in the power of self-hypnosis. The months that I had spent practicing it, I couldn't believe my ears when she beamed with pride. Don't worry, I'm famous for giving really small incisions. You won't have a big scar. I couldn't believe that after all this, she thought that a scar is what I was worried about. And then suddenly, as if there was no time left, within minutes a wheelchair came to wheel me into the OT. The staff disappeared. The other doctors came and it all felt surreal. I remember I had to go to the loo and when Mohit was taking me walking at snail's pace due to the pain, my doctor came shouting from behind. Abhi ye sab chhodo, seedha catheter lagayenge, jaldi karo. Mohit just stared at her in disbelief and said, doctor, she just needs to pee, please give her time. I just heard a ch-ch from the background and she stormed out. Chapter 4. The stage was set. I remember having a conversation with Mohit in the loo. He said, baby, I'm not comfortable with the way they are rushing you. You're already 8 cm dilated and have gone through the whole labor. Why now? I told him, I don't know what to do, baby. Just that we should trust the doctor. After all, what else could I do besides putting all my trust in her? With a heavy heart, I proceeded to the wheelchair, but I didn't know that the worst was yet to come. Outside the OT, suddenly I was told that Mohit cannot accompany me to the OT. I can't even begin to tell you how scared I was when I heard that. I tried to reason with my doctor that it was the first point mentioned in my birth plan. She started yelling again for some reason. I remember wondering what that reason was, but frankly, I didn't want to know. I just wanted Mohit to hold my hand. I was going in for surgery and was being asked to go without the man who accompanies me to office, to cafes, for shopping, to schools, to events, you name it. How could I go into surgery without him? He's my support system. He's my everything. We had prepared for this day for months together. He's my protector. And here I was, surrounded by people who all felt alien and insensitive. I could barely breathe through my surges. And my own doctor was yelling at me, Chavi, now it's all medicalized. This is protocol. I will not allow Mohit in my OT. I looked at her and with tears in my eyes and pain in my voice, I told her, doctor, why are you doing this to me? She turned her eyes away. I told her, if Mohit did not accompany me, I will walk out right now. The pediatrician whispered into her ear, let him come. He just wants to hold her hand. And my doctor took her phone and yelled again, I can't allow this. I'll have to speak to the authorities. And she exited. Later I came to know that all my friends who had delivered at this hospital were accompanied by their husbands for C-sections. They were even offered choice of music in the OT. But now I had to fight. And I fought with every ounce of energy in my body. आप सभी का क्या ख्याल है छवि मित्तल की ये कहानी जानकर हमें कमेंट सेक्शन में बताना ना भूले और टेली वर्ल्ड से जुड़े खबरों के अपडेट के लिए बने रहिए टेली मसाला के साथ।